Sure. The title of the talk today is Retrospective Analysis of Federal Regulation. And this is an area of growing interest in Washington and, frankly, around the country. President Obama issued an executive order on this subject in 2011, and there's interest in many other quarters in looking back and seeing what the benefits are and what the costs are of federal regulations. Benefits, of course, come in there are many different categories of benefits, and we're not fully able to measure all the categories for sure. And so many people question the legitimacy of the whole effort if we're in fact only looking at a subset of the benefits. And that's a very legitimate point. At the same time, we need to do the best we can. And the field, fortunately, is growing in strength. And so a lot of the newer work is much more comprehensive than previously. I think there are many benefits of doing retrospective analysis, okay? I think it's pretty clear that if, as a society, we are overestimating the net costs, or if we're, in fact, overestimating the net benefits, that this can lead to overly stringent or, in fact, not stringent enough regulation. And I think we need to be wary of that because we don't want to over-regulate or under-regulate. I think other benefits are a very important benefit, that the integrity of the whole effort. Many people have attacked environmental and other types of regulations, and I think the more one can validate the effects of regulation, the costs of regulation, the broadly determined benefits of regulation, one can add credibility to the whole regulatory effort. It's also possible that this analysis will identify improvements in methods so that going forward we can make better estimates than we're making today. And finally, it could identify specific regulations where there is either under or over regulation, and hence an opportunity for some reform.